Last weekend, one of the biggest fashion events happened. Trans Kenya Fashion Festival 2011 went down, and here's a sneak peek of how the event was like if you missed it. Enthusiastic fashion lovers, fashionistas, divas, name them, all mashed up at the prestigious place. If you fancy being at the center of attraction, you all know yourselves. Then you'd have enjoyed this Kodak moment. The mode of dressing was evidently fabulante.
Today is a weekend and I thought to myself, I should be in black, look elegant, look expensive and look posh at the same time. Then I had the flower to match my shoes.
Loud and proud. Fashion, fashion.
Ni mambo ya fashion show, and that's why I catch up on my skinny khaki na Aladdin chini kidogo na mimi naonekane niko top.
When you talk about dressing to impress, then this was the place you can get all that in one stop.
People are more fashion conscious and everybody wants to dress up and look good, especially the ladies, and even the men now actually beginning to, you know, to like recognize, okay, we need to look good as well. It's a really good event. Next time, you know, people now, after they see this, they'll recognize that it's something that, you know, they could be coming for. And it's not going to be next year that Alcott will showcase their stuff on stage. So sometime during this year or even early next year, maybe.
Here, we had the advantage of talking to two visiting international designers who showcased their kicking lines during the Trans Fashion Festival. Jatin Kucha from India and Ali Rahim Tula from Tanzania, and we saw their views on all matters fashion.
I essentially do universally accepted clothing. It may have slight hint of India, but it's a very, very slight hint. But everything is very universal, very wearable. I largely do a lot of evening wear.
Yes, that's what a lot of people think. And I think the best of fashion designers are men. But, you know, I just love the whole idea of colors and dressing people up. And it's like a curse, you know, when you see a girl dress walking down by the street and you're driving by and the first thing you notice is her clothes. You don't see the hair, you don't see the face, you don't see, just look at the clothes. So that's a sign. It's like, this is it.
Kucha describes himself as a floating soul, a total contrast to Ali's description of himself.
Ali is a young, crazy, energetic, colorful person. I love anything to do with nature, people, ladies, anything.
For me, the whole universe is where I belong. It just so happens that I live in India. But I'm pretty much all over the place. I love traveling, I love meeting people. And I think it's the love of meeting people that has actually given me this opportunity to do what I'm really doing. I mean, this is the best way to meet people, to make them look more beautiful.
Ali's interest in fashion started years ago. Before he fully dedicated his life to fashion, he was a teacher. Yes, a graphic and arts teacher. And what about couture?
I was always interested in making people and places look beautiful. So I also do some interior projects, interior design. And when I was in school, I was very good in arts, you know, drawing, sketching, painting. So this was something very natural.
How did their families take it at first when they say they want to be fashion designers?
I come from a business family, very conservative. So for them, it was very hard to deal with. They were like, you want to be a ladies' tailor? I said, yes. How are you going to survive? What is going to be your turnover? Because, you know, I mean, it's a business family, so that's the way they think. Mm-hmm. But I'm glad I stuck by what I believed in. And that's the reason I'm here with you lovely people.
How was your
My
mom?
Dad had no idea I was studying fashion. He thought I was doing graphics as well, actually. He also thought I was graduating in a graphics degree until when I graduated and came for my graduation. That's when I realized, oh, you're doing fashion? So I'm like, yes, Dad. Mm-hmm. He's like, okay. And at that point, you know, the parents are in denial, thinking, okay, he'll probably never take fashion as a career. It's probably just going to be a pastime thing. And slowly, and now I look back into it and I see my parents, and I feel that my parents are now so proud of me. Because he doesn't say much to me, but you know, dads are. He usually goes to his office and there are posters of me all over his offices and stuff. So, like, okay.
At least he's supporting
you. Yeah, it's a good feeling.
The love of meeting different people is what drove Ali into the vavavoom world of fashion, a trait which also seems to be quite familiar with couture.
Every country that I've shown in has been an absolute delight. For me, it's an opportunity to learn about new cultures, new food, which actually means new ideas. So I'm all, you know, I've been here like a couple of hours and I'm already making mental notes, you know, colors and ideas and what people like. And what I really enjoyed here was that there's a very clever fusion of contemporary with the traditional.
Kucha, who's now 39 and who's really looking forward to turning the big 40, tells us he launched his first line when he was 19 years old. And as for young Mr. Bubbly Ali,
I'm actually in, I have a line called Ali Ramtula Couture, which is a measure to made line, which is a very hot couture line. Mm-hmm. But I'm launching my ready to wear line in 2012. Mm-hmm. So by January, February 2012, you'll be able to buy an AR anywhere in one of your shops nearby.
And to delve a bit more into the lives of these men of style, we were curious, were there inspiring ladies who stand beside them?
Absolutely. I've been married for 12 years and I have a lovely wife and two lovely kids, and I'm already missing them.
And what about the energetic, colorful Ali?
This is very single. So if you have any girl in mind, please, Karibu, hook me up.
Before they left, they shared an inspiring word with upcoming fashion designers.
To begin with, there are no shortcuts. Your communication skills have to be excellent. Because a lot of times, you know, you come across very creative people, but they can't communicate. So you may have great ideas, great concepts, but if you cannot communicate across to other people, they're lost.
important thing is, if you think fashion is your thing, give it 100% and take it to the next level. Don't listen to anybody, don't listen to what anyone says. That is your dreams, that's the only way to make you happy. So do it and follow your dreams and be happy.